Hey guys, thanks for stopping in. My video today is vacuum cupping good for thoracic outlet syndrome, or can it have long-term bad effects down the road? And I've been doing it for more than 4 years now. In fact, I just looked it up to see when I ordered my first cupping set, just to be sure. It's been a little over 4 years now I've been doing vacuum cupping. And if you've seen my videos, you know I'm a big fan of it for thoracic outlet syndrome. In fact, you can see I was doing some on my shoulders last night. And for me, it helps loosen up the muscles. And the reason I'm even bringing this up is I'm in a Facebook group for people with TOS, thoracic outlet syndrome, and one guy had just bought a cupping set and said he liked it. It helped relax the muscles. And then there was a lady in there that, or I don't know if it was a lady, but person in there that said, you know, cupping is bad. You know, those purple marks, they break blood vessels, and that's going to cause scar tissue, and that's going to cause you more problems down the road, and going on and on. And I basically said I disagree, because I've been doing it for 4 years. I've had no problems. But she kept arguing, or person kept arguing and arguing. It's like, whatever. It's like one of those people who, you know, hasn't done something, but, you know, they have their opinion of it. It's like you see people like that all the time. Drives me crazy. If you haven't done something, then you don't know. You know, you got to try stuff for yourself to really have an opinion of it. And that's what I do. So, like I said, I've been doing cupping for 4 years now. For me, it really helps to relax the tight muscles that I get in my shoulders. And over time, my movement has actually gotten better. If it was causing me more scar tissue, in 4 years, I'd be getting stiffer and stiffer, I would think. And I'm getting looser and looser as time goes by. So, you know, I totally disagree with that. And, you know, look at Olympic athletes. Do you think, you know, Michael Phelps, you think he'd be doing vacuum cupping if he thought it might cause scar tissue and limit the range of motion in his shoulder? You know, when they win stuff by fractions of a second. I kind of seriously doubt that. And I actually Googled that. I said, can vacuum cupping cause scar tissue? And it's just, I didn't see anything about that. In fact, it's just the opposite. Vacuum cupping can help loosen up and soften up scar tissue. So it's just the opposite, which is what I've always thought, because I keep moving better all the time. In fact, I've used it on scars, on incisions where I've had surgery. In fact, I had a double spinal fusion surgery like 2 months ago now. So I have a big scar on my front, on my side, and also one on my back. So it's about time probably to start doing some cupping on those scars, because it helps soften them up. I have a big scar right here down the front of my chest where I had open heart surgery 5 years ago. And I used vacuum cupping on that scar, and it hurt like heck in the beginning. But after doing it a few times, it not only did it soften the scar up, but it faded a lot. So you really can't even see it that much. Before, it was kind of like bright red. And after cupping it a few times, it calmed down, and it's a lot more pale of just the color of the rest of my skin. So I think that cupping is you know, really good on scar tissue. So that's my story. It's like, you know, and I do this stuff to help people. I'm not selling anything here. So if I did some cupping and it caused me some weird, you know, effect or problem that, you know, I thought people should be aware of, I would be the first one to make a video and say that. I mean, I'm not selling anything, so I could care less what, if people buy cupping sets or they buy anything that I use in my videos, whether it's on this channel or cooking. It's like, I don't sell anything, so I could care less. I'll give you my opinion and show you stuff that I use that works for me, but it doesn't matter to me you know, what you do, you know, with it. I think a lot of people, when it comes to vacuum cupping, they just get freaked out by the purple marks. And, you know, those fade in a few days. It's no big deal. And I think I'm a little congested today. But anyway, when you have an area that's healthy on your body, you don't even really get purple marks anymore. The skin is just nice and pink when you pull the cup off, and it hardly leaves any mark at all. So obviously there's stuff going on up here in my shoulders all the time if after 4 years it still gets that purple from cupping. But like I said, I haven't seen any bad effects from it, any side effects. It works great for me, and I'm gonna keep on doing it. Thanks for watching, you guys, and I'll talk to you next time.